First step to our dream of a highly available Pi system is installing the first AF server. In this video, we'll be installing AF on Pi SRV01 with a remote SQL database as its backend, a database hosted on Pi SQL01. This is a very common configuration and has a fair few extra steps than a local SQL server installation like we did in the basis class. When we install AF on Pi SRV01, we'll be choosing a few different options. We'll choose to install the SQL scripts, but not run them. This copies a set of SQL scripts to the hard drive on Pi SRV01, everything we need to set up an AF SQL backend. We'll tell Pi SRV01 that its AF backend is Pi SQL01/SQL Express, but not to validate it yet. After it installs, we'll copy the scripts over to Pi SQL01 and then run them on the server itself. Now in real life, you may or may not be the person that actually runs these scripts on the SQL server. It's common for a database admin or DBA to run these scripts instead of you. We're going to run these scripts ourselves and see what they do. So they do a few things. They create and set up a database called PyFD on the SQL server, and also configure security so a local group has access to the database. But in the real world, it's very common to run this without admin access, and the script is unable to create the local groups it needs. We're going to run it and configure security manually. So we're going to give the service account that's running the AF server the permissions it needs on the new PyFD database on the SQL server. Again, we're on Pi SRV01, and we're going to install Asset Framework. So let's open up Pi Install Kits and run the Pi Server Installer. So right-click, run as administrator. Now, Pi Data Archive is already installed on this machine. We're going to run the installer again to add the Asset Framework feature on as well. So here I'm going to modify the installation and going to select Asset Framework Server. Now, don't worry about notifications or analysis. Our Pi SRV02 is going to be our notifications and analysis server later. We're going to leave everything at defaults and we're going to change some settings here. So our SQL Server connection, it isn't a local SQL Server connection. It is on Pi SQL01 and has a server name of SQL Express. We would like to install the scripts, but we do not want them to be executed. So deselect that. Another option has become available now. We do not want to validate the connection yet because during installation, the SQL Server won't be ready for us. We're going to go next here. We need to select a certificate for the RTQP service. We covered this in the basics course. We need an SSL certificate already created for us. This has been supplied to us by our IT department. Next, we need to type in service account names. Now we're using the same service account names as the basics class, and we are using group managed service accounts here. We check through the features that are going to be changed and we click modify. Right, looks like we're done. Okay, now let's see what it's installed. I'm going to navigate into Pi System, D drive, and inside the program files directory, inside PyPC, everything that isn't the Pi Data Archive tends to go in the PyPC folder. And inside Asset Framework, AF, this SQL folder. This SQL folder contains the scripts we need to run on the SQL database. I'm going to copy this SQL folder and then paste it in this shared folder directory. After it's been copied into our shared folder, I'm going to navigate to PySQL 01. I'm going to open the shared folder here and copy over this SQL folder. Okay. Let's close this. Open up the local copy of the SQL folder. Let's see what's inside. The most important file for us, at least right here, is this go.bat. This is the script we need to run that sets up the database. We're going to go into a command line now and run this file. So cd desktop, cd SQL, and I'm going to type in go.bat. We haven't provided it with everything it needs to run, so it tells us what we need to input. So it says go.bat. We're not going to use any optional parameters here. We're going to type in the name of the database. Here, our DB server is going to be PySQL 01 / SQL Express. Our database name is going to be PyFD, and I always recommend you type in PyFD as the database name for backwards compatibility reasons. Okay, that's that. Let's run it. Okay, looks like it's done, but there were some errors. As I said before, these errors are because we didn't run this as an administrator, so it didn't have permission to create groups. So let's go to this text file. And here it is. Here's our file. And just because I know what the error is, I'm going to search for it. I know AF servers is the name of a group that it attempts to create. And it looks like it's getting an error here. It tries to assign permissions to a local group called PySQL01/AF servers, and I can't find it. So this is what you'll see in real life if you try to run this script without admin rights, which most of the time you will be. Okay, let's fix this. So we're not going to fix this by creating local groups. We don't really need to. We just need to change the permissions on the database itself. So let's close this. And we're going to open up Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio. Okay, and we're open. Opening SQL Server Management Studio may or may not take longer than installing the entirety of Asset Framework Server. But okay, we're in finally. Now, we're going to connect and set up this security mapping. Now, here's our SQL Server. If you're not familiar with Microsoft SQL Server, don't worry too much. We've got to go step by step and configure access for our Asset Framework Server to the database we just set up with those scripts. Expand out security and right click on logins. We're going to make a new login. We're going to search for the group managed service account that we ran our Asset Framework Server under. So we'll change the locations. We'll search the entire directory and we'll change the object types to also search for service accounts. And the service account we're searching for is PySQL/SVC-PyAF$. And there we go. Now we need to configure a user mapping for this login. We're going to click on user mapping on the left-hand side. We're going to check the box for PyFD. And we're going to give this AF query engine an AF server permissions. This gives it the permission it needs to make changes to the PyFD database and be an AF server. Okay. And with that, we can go and test it. So I'm going to go back to PySRV01. I'm going to open up PySystem Explorer. And it says the AF server PySRV01 only contains the system configuration database. This is good. You can actually see that it contains a database. Great, it works. Do we want to create a user database this time? Yes. Let's name our database development. And OK. And it works. Now we have a asset framework server with a remote SQL backend. The steps we went through there are very close to what you would do in real life, but most likely you would need a SQL database administrator to do everything we did on PySQL 01.